Hello, everyone, and welcome back. We're here reacting to Germany's entry for Eurovision 2022. None of us have heard the song, and I will remind you all this. Yeah, this is just our opinions. We will probably change our minds after hearing it four or five times, six, ten times before Eurovision. but yeah, we are going to see what Malik Harris has to offer this year. His song is called Rockstars. I'm told that this is a singer-songwriter style, as I guess basically all of the entries in the German final were. This is the first time Germany has had a national final like this that everyone could vote on in quite a few years. So, yeah, people were excited to be able to have some input. So yeah, we'll see what Germany has chosen this year. You guys ready?
Already gave themselves 12 points.
They already gave themselves, Germany, 12 points.
Look where we are. We used to be the rock stars. Looks kind of like the what's his face from SNL.
Trying to say Pete Davidson?
What?
You talking about Pete Davidson?
Yeah.
When time is moving so far,
switch there was a way to know. I mean, he's got a microphone and piano in front of him.
Okay. I like what's happening.
Be interested to see like what the final product is gonna be. Is this the second song with a spoken verse? Very genuine.
I love that the background pictures have like shown his progression.
Where he came from. Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna cry.
I'll only cry if you cry. We probably should make Carlina talk first.
Okay. So, I wasn't sure when the song started that I was gonna like that even in the least. But I think that's something beautiful, is that I went from that to actually like getting into the lyrics and hearing this story that was being told, which I think it's becoming more and more rare in general music, like across the board. You get so many songs that are repetitive lyrics, just over and over, repeating the same things or the same themes, and you just don't get a lot of variety. So I really appreciated about that about the song, and I'm gonna assume that's his dad in
I'm pretty sure
the
he was one of the images.
Yeah, so that was when I about lost it. I didn't lose it until the Ukraine thing, and then my whole heart, like taking that moment on the stage to say something that's so simple but so important right now.
And I had seen that thumbnail before too, so like I knew it was coming up.
Were you
And then
just
yours,
waiting?
like, and then yours, like, and I'm like,
You had a little bit of
hold
preparation for it.
together. I don't know where I have to sit with this song a few times to kind of know how I feel about it. His style vocally is not something that I really tend to go for. Like it's fine, but it's not something that I usually seek out. Kind of clipping off a lot of the notes and more of the spoken style. But at the same time, he did a good job at it. So it's not like, it wasn't certainly wasn't bad by any means. I do like the songwriting part of it. I like it lyrically. And even though it kind of the melody just kind of spun continually along, I didn't feel like it needed anything different to happen. Like it takes you along in a straight line, and that was fine. And a lot of singer-songwriter styles will kind of do that. Like they'll repeat the same exact musical theme but add different words. And so I think it was really fitting. I hope that this will give Germany a better placement than they've had the last few years. I think it will. I think the message is strong. I know a lot of the songs this year are kind of looking back again at like, oh, how life used to be and where are we gonna go from here? But I think this puts it nicely in a way that people will relate to. Thoughts?
So I felt like the lyrics definitely were very close to him, and the thing that always happens is whenever people do spoken word in a song like this, it's always the most meaningful to them. But it's always the least interesting to me, not lyrically, but I just
Sure.
don't like the sound of
It
it.
doesn't make you listen in more, it makes you kind of disengage.
So yeah, I felt like his performance of it and his lyrics were good. I thought melodically it wasn't very interesting. I feel like one of my friends could just write it melodically, but that makes
I
it
agree.
very raw, I feel like.
Yeah, it makes it relatable in a different sort of way. Like you could go to a local bar and hear something like this. It's like he's a person you know, somebody down the street. Interesting.
I would second that last point. Like, I guess it's endearing in a lot of ways because it gives you, and I don't know how long he's been doing this. He's clearly a young artist, but how long he's been, professionally, he's been doing music professionally. Hard to know, but it does give the feel of a very, very raw, very, uncoached kind of thing, which, it has some organic appeal to it where it doesn't feel like he's, quite as much been churned through the, pop music scene, right? And it's not overproduced like that, and that's great. I agree on the vocal style. I don't think I've expressed this here yet, but I've expressed it multiple times in privately. But the far, far,
Oh.
so far, or whatever, how, what, I don't, is there a word for that? For the four, for
So there's
the
a very
very
popular
near.
pronunciation shift, especially in music, that's been happening in pop music, especially stuff that comes out of California, where it's you'll basically add a diphthong where there isn't one, and just draw out the vowel. Instead of having one pure vowel, you kind of
Give
change
us
the
an
vowel.
example,
I
because I'm
don't
not
want
doing it
to.
right.
I don't want
I
to.
can't think of one right now. Time. No,
No,
time is a diphthong. It
yeah,
is a time
but
weird.
I legitimately hate that. That is like, I don't like the sound of it. I don't like that it's become basically commonplace to do it. It's it, I there's just like many things I don't like about it. Overall, I do like the song. I even actually the spoken word part, he kind of channels at the very end of it a little bit of Eminem in that,
Yeah, I was getting
which
some
was
Stan
I was like, wow, okay, that's like old school
vibes.
Eminem right there.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I can get behind that. So it
Yeah.
was interesting, and he, you know, ramped up the intensity a bit to do that. So I like that about it. Overall, I liked the song, but definitely I could do without the modern pop inflection in the vocal style.
One example
So,
would be like instead of saying walk, you'd say wyke.
yeah, exactly. That's exactly it.
Yeah.
Hate it
Oh, that
so
hurts me
much.
inside.
It's so terrible. It is the worst
It's
thing in pop music today.
a thing. It's That's a strong statement.
I stand by
Yeah, our opinions are all
that statement.
perfectly reasonable.
That
All right, well.
said, I don't listen to a lot of lyrics. I just hear that inflection. So I don't, there could be worse things in pop
Why?
music that I'm not listening to.
Great. Well, that is our initial thoughts on this song. I'm definitely gonna hear it many more times. I don't know if they'll be listening to it again before Eurovision. We'll definitely have to hear it maybe before we do our draft and compete against each other to see which one of us wins Eurovision this year. We'll give you more details as we get closer. If you were here last year, you know how it works. But for now, we're going to sign off. Thank you for joining us. Yeah, let us know your thoughts on this song in the comments, and we'll be back with another video next time. Bye!
Bye.
I'm drooling.